हेलो माय एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ हर्ष अभिचंदानी, हेड ऑफ एमएल फोरम वीआईआईटी, विल बी द वन टू एक्सप्लेन यू हाउ टू डिप्लॉय मशीन लर्निंग मॉडल्स बाय रेस्ट एपीआईज यूजिंग द जैंगो रेस्ट फ्रेमवर्क. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन अबाउट दिस डिप्लॉयमेंट इज दैट व्हाट इज एन एपीआई. एपीआई स्टैंड्स फॉर एन एप्लीकेशन प्रोग्रामिंग इंटरफेस. सो व्हाट इज एन एपीआई? You must be knowing that you can book movie tickets online, right? So considering PVR cinemas, so PVR's API is used by BookMyShow. I might be booking tickets through BookMyShow. You might be booking tickets from some other application like Paytm. So the same API is used by Paytm to book the same PVR theater movie tickets. So in an API, the visual content or display doesn't matter. What matters is data and data only. As machine learning and data science engineers, the styling of the UI or other stuff isn't your job. Inputting data and getting a result in a user-friendly way is our only motive. We can't sell our Jupyter Notebook codes to a person or a company with no programming background, right? Hence, APIs are made and sold to them. Further, they will style it, use it in any way they feel like. But our only job is to make a model, fuse it into an API, and give a user-friendly way to the customer to execute it. So one of the best ways to make an API is using Django's REST API framework. REST API framework uses JavaScript object notation type of data, that is JSON data. So everything and everywhere is only done by playing with different forms of data. Though most commonly used types are XML format and JSON format. XML is, you can see, like the HTML scripting, like greater and less than signs are used. And in JSON, you can see curly braces are used. So your REST APIs are used with JSON data. So in this introduction video of this course, there are certain requirements I would like to do. So Django is a framework based on the Python programming language. So check whether you have Python 3 first. Then if you have Python 3 on your Anaconda terminal or command terminal or any Python terminal which you have, put three commands which are mentioned here to get Django on your device. So first is pip install Django. Second is pip install Django REST framework. And third is pip install Django REST framework -JWT. Then the second requirement is that you need to have any code editor like Atom, which is my preference, or Sublime Text, Visual Studio Code by Microsoft, PyCharm, anything. My only suggestion here is that please don't use Spider or Eclipse or anything with plugins that have automation for everything, as you will not be able to experience the true essence of Django. Everything will be automated. The commands and everything will get printed on it own or typed on it own. But that isn't the right way or the correct way to explore Django. So I would like to begin with the basic initializations of Django, that is how to start a Django project. After you have installed Django and you have your code editors, so open your terminal or command prompt, and there mention inside, make a folder first, a directory, and inside that mention these commands which are mentioned on the right hand side. That is, in order to create a project, Django -fin admin start project, and then your project name. Then go inside that project directory. You will see that a project directory is formed with certain predefined Python codes. And inside that, then go and mention Django hyphen admin start application app underscore name और python manage.py start app underscore name. Now you might be getting confused. What is a project? What is an application? So basically, modular programming concept is applied in Django. What happens is, in Django, you can make separate modules or functions of your project and club them together. So the main bigger entity will be the project, and inside that there will be separate small applications. So now when you create the Django project folder, you will see your project directory, your application directory, manage.py python application, and db.sqlite3. Project directory, I explained, the main big entity. Application directory depends on how many applications you make. Each application will have its own directory. Manage.py is a driver code for your whole Django application. You don't need to tweak anything in it. And what is db.sqlite3? So here we come to know the most important significance of Django, that is, it has its own database. You don't need to learn MySQL, PostgreSQL, or any type of database language system. You just need to understand how to handle the database of Django itself, and it will do the rest. You don't need to learn a separate language for that, or queries and everything. Now inside, when you see the project directory, when you will create your Django project, you will find these files, that is init.py, settings.py, urls.py, wsgi.py, and anything what you would like to define, you can also create your own files and folders and then mention it there. And similarly, inside the application directory, you will find init.py again, admin.py, apps.py, models.py, test.py, and views.py. So in settings.py, you can mention and change your settings, like mention the applications that you have created inside the project settings.py. Then web applications and websites run through URLs, right? You click on a URL and then it takes you somewhere else, or it does whatever it's meant to. So that section of the project can be handled in urls.py. WSGI.py is used when it comes to deployment to an actual server or cloud or something. Then when it comes to application directory, admin.py, it handles, as its name suggests, the administration part, like the model. In models, we can create the database tables, and that has to be registered in the app, admin.py. Apps.py, test.py. For now, at this initial stage, we will not play with any test.py. It's just to check whether your code is working efficiently or not. And views.py, whatever you want to display on your web app and everything can be handled through views.py, your logic and everything. Now, this Django framework is so strong that, trust me, you don't have to write a single line of HTML code here for Django REST. It is such a revolutionary thing that websites are formed without writing a single line of HTML code. Yes, HTML is necessary when it comes to making normal Django projects and everything. Whether you want to make a e-commerce project or something, at that time it will be necessary. But I told you, as a machine learning and data science engineers, there's no need to look after the UI, the design and everything. Our sole focus is making an API, right? So now that picture of the ship at the first page or the first screen must have confused you, right? When you are a kid, whenever you used to see a ship, at least for my experience, I used to remember Titanic. So yes, first we learn a normal Django REST API from scratch, and then we'll make our machine learning API. And what machine learning API? It's so very exciting, right? Our machine learning model, our web app, will tell you whether you or any other person, when we input the data, would have survived the Titanic mishap. Like if you were present at the Titanic ship, like you would have survived that incident, you would have been alive or dead at that time. So first, let's make a basic college and student communication API just to understand and get a hang of Django. And then we'll move on to our famous Titanic dataset model, which will predict whether the person survived or died. So our flow, which I mentioned, we'll first make a college API. We'll then dip, in order to just get a fresh mind, we'll change our subject and we'll go to pythonanywhere.com and deploy it. Then in part two, we'll make our machine learning API with the Titanic dataset. The deployment of college API and machine learning API, the process is full on same. So I'll deploy the college API for you and you can try the machine learning API yourself. So that's it for this introductory session of our course. Thank you. Hope to see you in our next video. And I would like you to please subscribe and like our channel and make our reach more and more broader. Thanks a lot once again. Hope to see you in our next session.